The South-North Water Transfer Project in China. China is a country with a huge population, a fast-growing economy and a vast territory. However, it also faces a serious challenge of water scarcity, especially in its northern regions. The uneven distribution of water resources. The increasing demand for water and the impacts of climate change have created a situation where some parts of the country have too much water while others have too little. To address this problem, China has embarked on an ambitious and controversial project to transfer water from the south to the north through three canal systems. This project, known as the South-North Water Transfer Project, SNWTP, is one of the largest and most expensive engineering projects in human history. The background and rationale of the SNWTP. The idea of transferring water from the south to the north of China dates back to 1952, when Mao Zedong reportedly said, "There's plenty of water in the south, not much water in the north. If at all possible, borrowing some water would be good." However, it was not until 2002 that the construction of the project officially began. The main reasons for launching the SNWTP are: to alleviate water shortage and support economic development in northern China. Northern China accounts for 64% of China's cultivated land, 46% of its population and 50% of its GDP, but only 19% of its water resources. Per capita water availability in northern China is less than 500 cubic meters per year, far below the international standard of water stress. The lack of water has limited the agricultural production, industrial output, and urban expansion in northern China, and threatened its food security and social stability. To balance the water supply and demand between different regions, southern China, especially the Yangtze River Basin, has abundant water resources, but also suffers from frequent floods and water pollution. Transferring some water from the south to the north can help reduce the flood risks, improve the water quality and optimize the water allocation in southern China, to cope with climate change and environmental degradation. Climate change has increased the variability and uncertainty of precipitation patterns in China, making droughts and floods more frequent and severe. Moreover, overexploitation of groundwater, deforestation, soil erosion and desertification have worsened the water situation in northern China. Transferring water from the south to the north can help replenish the groundwater, restore the ecosystems and mitigate the impacts of climate change. The design and implementation of the SNWTP. The SNWTP consists of three routes: the eastern route, the central route and the western route. Each route has different sources, destinations, capacities and challenges. The eastern route is based on an upgrade of the Grand Canal, which is a historical waterway that connects Beijing and Hangzhou. The water from the Yangtze River is pumped by stations along the canal and through a tunnel under the Yellow River to reservoirs near Tianjin. The eastern route is mainly used for irrigation and industrial purposes. The central route is a new canal that runs from Danjiangku Reservoir on the Han River, a tributary of the Yangtze River, to Beijing and Tianjin via a giant aqueduct that crosses over 1,000 rivers and canals. The central route is mainly used for domestic and municipal purposes. The western route is still under study and has not been approved yet. It involves diverting water from three tributaries of the Yangtze River near Biankala Mountain through tunnels across the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau to arid regions in northwest China. The western route is expected to be used for ecological restoration and agricultural development. The benefits and costs of the SNWTP. The SNWTP has brought some benefits to both southern and northern China. According to official statistics, by 2018, the project had transferred more than 30 billion cubic meters of water to northern China, benefiting more than 120 million people and 16 million hectares of farmland. The project has also helped reduce the flood risks, improve the water quality and increase the hydropower generation in southern China. Moreover, the project has created many jobs, stimulated economic growth and enhanced regional cooperation. However, the SNWTP also has some costs and challenges. The project has displaced hundreds of thousands of people, destroyed many cultural relics and natural habitats, and disrupted the ecological balance along the routes. The project has also faced technical difficulties, such as leakage, sedimentation, corrosion, and earthquake risks. Furthermore, the project has raised social and ethical issues, such as water pricing, water rights, water governance, and public participation. The project has also been criticized for being too costly, too risky, and too unsustainable. The future and alternatives of the SNWTP. The SNWTP is still an ongoing project that requires continuous monitoring, evaluation, and adjustment. The Chinese government plans to complete the construction of the eastern and central routes by 2030, and to start the feasibility study of the western route by 2020. The government also intends to improve the water efficiency, water conservation, and water management in both southern and northern China, and to promote the integrated and coordinated development of water resources. However, some experts and activists have suggested that there are better alternatives to the SNWTP, such as reducing water demand by improving water use efficiency, recycling wastewater, adopting water-saving technologies, and changing consumption patterns. Increasing water supply by developing renewable energy sources, such as solar and wind power, that do not consume water, and by harvesting rainwater and restoring wetlands. Enhancing water security by strengthening water governance, enforcing water laws and regulations, implementing water pricing and taxation policies, and involving stakeholders and communities in water decision-making. The SNWTP is a massive and complex engineering project that aims to solve China's water problems by transferring water from the south to the north. The project has brought some benefits to both regions, but also some costs and challenges. The project is still in progress and needs constant improvement and adaptation. The project is not a panacea for China's water woes, but rather a part of a comprehensive and holistic approach to water management.